What's going on, everyone? This is Steve Place from investingwithoptions.com, where we teach people just like you how to become great option traders. Today, we're looking at RH, and RH stands for Restoration Hardware, and this is a high-end retail company. If you haven't noticed, retail stocks have been on kind of a tear ever since there was this retail apocalypse. You know, in 2016 and in parts of 2017, depending on what you look at, a lot of apparel stocks, a lot of furniture stocks got hit really, really hard. Since then, a lot of them have recovered. The most recent example I can think of would be something like Lululemon, where it broke multi-year highs. But you can tell, you know, similar kind of idea where we see this, this push right here to the downside, 2016, 2017. Another one that I think is a good example is Under Armour, which pushed in 2017, continuation right here in late 2017, and then it's finally starting to catch a bit of a bid. All right, so that kind of theme I think is working really well right here. But Restoration Hardware has some really nice features about it in the short term. First off, it just had earnings. And if my data will load, there we go. Earnings, really good. Right, this is what we call a good earnings reaction, right? The stock ran from about 120 all the way up to 145, saw some continuation up to about 165, and is currently going under a post-earnings bull flag pattern. Now, under normal market conditions, when you see this kind of move, the stock will tend to continue in the direction of the earnings move. I'm gonna go back to Lulu as a great example. Lulu broke out on earnings right here, saw continuation. Broke out on earnings right here, saw continuation. Broke out on earnings here, saw continuation. I'm expecting that same kind of idea to get set up in RH. Now, what's really interesting about RH right now is this number, 35%. And 35% is how much of their float is currently short. So you have one third of the stock currently owned by short sellers. Now think about what it would feel like to be a short seller who did not start shorting right here, right? If you started shorting around this area right here between 80 and 100. So let's say you've got a short on at 85 and then it starts to ramp up and then earnings hits and all of a sudden, you know, look at this on a 10-year time frame. We're breaking out to new all-time highs. This is new multi-year highs right here. What do you think you're going to have to do? You're going to have to cover. It's very rare. I think it's pretty rare. I can't really think of any near-term cases. Normally, when a stock is highly shorted, it tends to be in more volatile price action. Right? It tends to see strong moves to the upside and downside within the context of a range. For anyone to be short right here, they're probably at a loss. And if we see any kind of move above 160, you know, that we're going to find some uncle points, some pain points where people start crying uncle and we see that strong move higher. So you have the combination of post-earnings announcement drift where we should expect this post-earnings bull flag to see some continuation higher. On top of that, we have 35% of the short currently float currently short. There we go, had it backwards. So we can and should, I think, expect this stock to rally. Now, Restoration Hardware does have options. They're not the most liquid in the world, about a 40-cent bid-ask spread, but they're liquid enough to consider a trade. Here's what I did when I just did a quick glance at the stock. The July 170 calls, all right? The July 170 calls have 30 days to expiration, so it's about a month out. And 170 is right here, okay? So it's about 20 points away, but given the normal volatility of the stock, right, that's pretty close to the upper end of the range. This option right here has a delta of about 20. That means the delta of an option is directly related to the expectation that it'll expire in the money. So the options market is currently pricing a 1 in 5 chance that the stock will be above 170 going into OPEX. To me, that seems low. To me, that seems very, very low. Okay, given how the stock's traded, the strong move on earnings, the 35% short exposure, the odds that we're going to be above 170 after options expiration or close to it is a heck of a lot higher than 20%, which means we want to consider net option buying positions. Now, there's a couple different ways to play it. You know, I think going out and buying something like the July 170 calls, just straight up full risk, they're going for like $2 right now. It's going to be a good risk reward trade. So that's what this trade is. It's buying the Jewel 170 calls. It's a very aggressive trade. You got 30 days left to expiration. A lot can happen between now and then, right? If something bad comes out of the stock and it goes to zero, right, then you're only out the debit paid, which is $210. If we see a test of 170, right, that's about right here, you're looking at about 750. So this right here is about a 3-to-1 risk payout. And then what you can do is if the stock continues to run, you know, you can sell half and you can just continue to ride this profit curve higher. All right. So that's pretty good risk reward. I think that there's also another really good trade right here. And that's going to be the July 160, 170 bull call spread. So this is where you go out and you buy the 160 call and then you sell the 170 call. Now that trade is currently going for $2.35. Now this is what the trade looks like. Okay, instead of having a break even all the way at 170, your break even is now about 163. Go back and look at a chart of Restoration Hardware. That post earnings high right here, what's that number? That's 164.5. So that's a reasonable level to expect, you know, if we break out and we break to new highs, that's your break-even level into expiration, right? If we see a move to 170 on this trade, you know, your maximum risk is 230. Your tag of 170 is going to be 334, but here's a cool thing. If we continue to run or if we just hold, you now have positive theta and you continue to earn money over time. So you can look at this and, you know, you go buy the 160, you sell the 170, and now your maximum reward, and here we can do this really quick, we can do the calculation really quick, is a 10 wide spread, you're paying 235, right? That's your absolute maximum risk. So you subtract 10, you subtract 235 out of 10, and because I can't do math in my head, I'm just gonna guess it's about 765. Okay, and I'm just gonna get a calculator real quick and do this. 10 out of 235, 765. So 765 maximum return out of 235 is 3.2. So your R multiple, your risk unit, assuming full risk, is going to be about 3x. Very similar to what we're doing on the call buy side, but slightly less risky. Okay. So this is one that I think is a pretty good candidate for a short squeeze, pretty good candidate of testing these highs and breaking out above these highs, probably going to run to $180 a share over the near term. Now, if you take this trade, and again, this is up to you, I'm not a broker dealer, the standard disclaimers apply and everything. What you can then do is you can, if we see a run, you close out the 160s and then you move them up to the 165s. And if it continues to run, you take the 170 short call you have, leave it on, but then you move this long call to August, and then you have a calendar. All right, so that kind of idea will probably continue to work. All right, so look for trend continuation, look for a post earnings run, look for a retest of those highs, look for a short squeeze. You know, you can go look at buying calls straight up, which is going to give you some very fast risk reward, or you can go look at buying some call spreads, which is also going to give you some really nice upside returns, just a little bit more conservative. If you like those kinds of ideas, check out my website at investingwithoptions.com and subscribe to my channel on YouTube. Have a great day.